Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Matt, Jessica Knappen, Joe Wilkinson, Nigel Ung, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jim
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. You can play along at home or you can go to bed. OK, fair enough. Night-night, sleep tight. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's team captain John Richardson! John's wife once said they don't have any nice pictures of them as a couple, and that's because John's in all of them.
Still nothing as funnier as the idea that you say night-night, sleep tight.
Do you not say night-night, sleep tight?
You don't say that.
Say night-night. Yeah.
You blow a little kissy.
I don't say anything back, of course, because of the ball gag. What do you say at the end of the... What do you say?
I say, right, piss off, then. That's as much of me as you can handle, is it?
And joining John tonight is Jessica Knappen. Jessica once had a job where she showed people how to use a coffee machine in a John Lewis. Although, sadly, after a few months, they replaced her with a sign. Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Lee Mack! Lee is actually a vegan and from the north, so I think that means he will have a kebab, but he won't pick the salad out. And Lee's teammate, it's Joe Wilkinson! Whenever he's not on Countdown, you can catch Joe live in your local park asking passers-by if he can walk their dog. Wait, that doesn't say walk. Joe.
Hello.
If they made a film about your life, who would play you?
Cool. How did they get the funding? No, I mean, that's the hard bit. You remember the lady who put a cat in a bin? Remember her? She's got range.
That'd be a great IMDb page. Cat in a bin video, and biopic of Joe Wilkinson.
Yeah. And it'd be nice to keep it in the family.
Lee, what's the most important lesson you've what's the most important lesson you've passed on to your children?
Learn how to read a card. The most important lesson I've passed on to my children, a cure for hiccups is to run into the road blindfolded. But it is high risk. Just have loads of kids, play the numbers game.
OK, Jessica, have you got any strange habits?
Well, actually, I think John will relate to this one because I've been doing a lot of decluttering in my house. That's something that I've been enjoying. Because there's a whole technique that's like Marie Kondo, you will have heard of it, and where you have to go through your house and if something sparks joy, then you keep it. Right. But everything else you have to throw away.
So you just keep the booze.
How I ended up in an empty house just holding a vibrator.
It's very different to the other version of Countdown, this, isn't it? I was watching the real Countdown and there was a funny little anecdote about tea.
John, what traits do you hope to pass on to your daughter?
Well, nothing physical, obviously. Goes without saying. No, I don't know. I don't want my daughter to have anything I've got. Nothing physical. You know, I watch her filing away her Lego when I tell her to, and she hasn't really got the confidence to know whether to go by colour or brick pattern. You know, and I think, do I want this future for her? Probably not. Do I want her to have my willpower? Probably not. I'm trying to not drink every night. She hasn't had a drop for 4 years. You know? She's already better than me. And she's got no reason not to drink, really. Nothing to do. No work. Doesn't drive. Get on it. The younger generation don't drink as much as we do. They're like...
You mean children?
What do they drink? That vinegar drink they drink, don't they?
Yeah. What's it called? Vinegar.
No, kombucha, that one.
Yeah.
Like, the nice drink.
Yeah, I do kombucha.
Yeah, me. Yeah.
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 Kombucha.
Yeah.
What's kombucha?
It's one of them little trees that are like big trees.
That's a bonsai.
Oh, fuck off. Might look an idiot.
OK. Lee, did you bring a mascot?
Yes, I've got a mascot, Jimmy. I went for the... for this. It's a ladybird. And the ladybird, not a lot of people know, that's some interesting facts, the ladybird is a good-look charm in Germany, and it's called the Glückskappe. I thought you'd like that, Susie. A little less known fact about the ladybird. It's a merciless killer, genuinely, that would happily eat its own siblings to survive. So I thought you'd like that, Jimmy. And the final bit of fact about the ladybird that not a lot of people know, and this is genuinely a true fact about this so-called good luck charm, they actually have voracious sex lives and transmit a lot of sexually transmitted diseases. So, one for you, Joe.
OK. Joe, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I do, Jimmy. People find it strange that when I use the toilet, I sit facing the cistern.
What, sorry?
When I use the toilet, I sit facing the cistern.
So you're hugging the cistern.
I don't know how many times I'm going to have to say that. I sit facing the cistern. It's well documented. I talked about it on many, many shows. I'm not ashamed of it. And Sue Lawley does it. You know the broadcaster Sue Lawley. She does it.
I don't think you can say that about Sue
Lawley.
No,
you can. Have you read her autobiography? It's incredible. I'm sure everyone's read it. It's because.
What's it called? It's
called Desert Island Discussions. It's my Bible. And, OK, I'll just read the first paragraph and, you know. Studio 6... This is how she starts. It's fucking incredible. Studio 16B is about as far removed from a desert island as you can imagine. We're off! Paul's going to sleep. I'm not there! No ray of sunshine, or any other form of weather for that matter, penetrates those basement walls. Fuck. Tucked away at the end of a maze of corridors. It's cleaned quite often, but often remains dusty. Fucking hell, Sue. I'm welling up here. It's also a victim of an eccentric central heating system that only allows two temperatures, stifling hot or freezing cold. Oh, and by the way, I shit-facing the system.
Jim Wilkinson there, with Sue Lawley spoken. Apologies to Sue Lawley if she's watching. She's a national treasure. It's not really in there, is it?
It's mentioned 56 times.
Can we all just make a pact? We're all going to try it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
We're going to try it.
Are we talking ones?
We're talking ones?
Yeah.
I've never done a one without a two. Never. And I mainly use urinals. Awful.
John, you got a mascot?
Well, you know tech, everyone's wearing gadgets and gizmos these days, aren't they, to help them with their fitness and their diet. I'm not into all that, but I have developed a new app. This is my version of a Fitbit, but it measures your cleaning that you're up to and it tells you your basic stats. It's called You Missed a Bit Bit.
Sorry, what's it called again?
You Missed a Bit Bit.
You Missed a Bit Bit.
So You Missed a Bit Bit. This is You Missed a Bit Bit. And you can see the user Rico, level 87. Don't expect to get to 87. You simply won't. You get your stats up like this and you can look into specific cleaning you've done. Click on the Hoover icon there to get your vacuuming stats up. You can see 27.4 miles vacuumed. People like having sex with each other. That's something we've capitalised on with the app. So there's a dating app. You get your picture will come up there, and people who look clean, wipe left. people who look dirty, wipe right five or six times at least, to be honest, before you get rid of them. And then you go back to your home screen and it's all synced up. It'll give you little updates. It'll ping if you get any... holy shit. happy John. Got me marigold badge for cleaning behind the toilet. That's wonderful. Didn't use any... Yours, I was in your dressing room before. All receipts behind there. It'll tell you all your levels there. You can see the drain clean is dangerously low. My wife insists on showering every day. It's a bloody nightmare with clogged up hair. And speaking of Lucy, you can sync them up. So if you live with your partner, I've got mine synced to Lucy's. So, you know, I get updates from what she's been up to. So you see there, it says she's on the bathroom. 14 minutes. She had them. There's times I'm out on tour and it says she's cleaning the bedroom and I can see she's just lying there, but her heart rate is through the roof. And when I get back, all she's done is change the sheets. You know, you're fooling bloody hell.
John Richard thinks you missed a bit there.
Jessica, have you got a mask on?
Well, yeah, because I've been spending a lot of time in LA, so I don't like to get stressed now. That's my new thing. So I've brought something to soothe me.
What's your mascot?
My mascot is my massage therapist, Nada.
Oh.
Here he is.
Nada.
Just here to relax me. Nada's so zen, nothing you can say can faze him. So just a little bit, just on the neck, the shoulders, all the way down the spine and round to the front. he's not out. In case you're worried, he is in my bubble. And my husband's fine about that.
Well, look at the size of him.
Jimmy, you're dribbling, mate.
Honestly.
Big fella, isn't he?
He's a big fella, but can he fight?
Jess, were you finding it relaxing?
I'm so relaxed, I might fall asleep. Night, sleep tight, night, night. What did you say?
Do you know who loves a massage?
Don't you dare.
could you throw a bit of that anti-vax on your hands?
God.
It's really, I feel
brace
like...
yourself, John, he's going in.
So I think just, if you, I'm not sure if you can do this, but if you could just pick him up under the arms.
If I pay you £50, will you wear him like a puppet?
It's good, isn't it?
Look how relaxed he is.
I'm not really getting into the spirit.
Cockington on toast.
I think we have to end it there before you pull his spine out. As they're fine.
Cheers, mate. Okay.
Wow, you look so relaxed.
I'll call you if I need you.
Over in Dixon Corner, it's Nigel Ung. Nigel used to work as a data scientist analysing statistics. You should talk to Susie about that, Nigel. Might stop her wittering on about one of her shitty books. It's your first time on the show. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm originally from Malaysia and I've lived in the UK 6 years now. I moved here mainly for comedy and so I can drink tap water and not shit myself. Sometimes I would FaceTime with my parents back in Malaysia and I just go, don't try this at home, Mom.
Is Nigel a common name in Malaysia?
Oh, I'm glad you asked that. A lot of people think it's weird for an Asian guy to be named Nigel. And, you know, the truth is, a lot of Malaysians, we adopted British first names because we used to be a British colony. But the thing is, you guys left us in 1957, which means all of our names are still stuck in a fucking era. You didn't bother to send us any software updates. We all have all like English geezer names, you know? I know Asian Harolds, Collins, Keiths. My brother's name is Gary. I even know a Malaysian Basil. Basil Wang, great guy.
And with Nigel, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie may seem boring, but get to know her and you'll soon realise you were right in the first place. You get a lot of fans contacting you on Twitter.
One thing that made me laugh quite recently, I'm sure he's not a fan, but I had my dressing room was next to Gary Lineker's. So Gary tweeted, word of the day, adjoining or something, because our dressing rooms were next to each other, and he took a picture of my dressing room door and his, and mine said, and I knew you'd like this, Jimmy, it said, Susie Dent, maximum capacity, 2 persons.
I better not say anything else.
No, I think that's left.
Sue Lawley's already
Gary good. Lineker only shits facing his sister.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel is a mathematician and daytime TV presenter, like Archimedes if he hosted Homes Under the Hammer.
I'd watch that.
Rachel, it says here you recently had your first night out in almost 2 years. How'd it go?
It was great. We went to a burlesque slash boylesque show, because there was kind of boys doing burlesque as well. It had been too long since we'd been out together, because there was a sexy lady in the middle with just nipple tassels and, like, a, you know, sequin thong in a champagne glass with fluorescent liquid, and she had this big sponge thing, and she was dripping all this fluorescent liquid all over herself. And Pasha and I just looked at each other, and he said it reminded us of our toddler in the bath. It just was the same motion as she'd, like, play with her little duckies, and we're just watching there like, oh, isn't that nice? We need to get out more, for sure.
Or less! Maybe you need to stay at home. OK, the prize the teams will be competing for this evening is this, the Countdown Picture Hanging Kit. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. John, Jessica, you get the first pick of the letters.
Vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Jessica.
Oh.
And a consonant.
L.
Textbook.
And another consonant.
S.
Vowel. I know there's a way of doing this right and a way of doing it wrong. Another vowel, please.
I.
Consonant.
T.
Another consonant.
P.
Yeah, don't need the question mark.
A vowel! A vowel.
A.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one. L.
Oh, sorry. And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Jimmy, what did I say? Eventually this Botox is going to be too much.
John, how many?
Well, I'll try a 7, but I don't think it's a word.
OK, no. Jessica, how many?
4.
4, OK. Lee, how many?
7.
OK, and Joe, how many?
I'm not interested. I just want to look at that. 4.
What's your 4?
Pill.
OK. I might just pop this balloon. Hang on. There's a... Joe, what's your 4?
I said 5.
Earlier when you said 4?
Yeah, I said 5.
OK, what's your 5?
Pills.
I think I can see what's happened here. Jessica, you're 4?
Yeah, slip.
John?
You're well, 7? I've put spatial, but with a T.
Ooh,
and that's
yeah,
not a word.
Yeah, yeah.
Is
that's
it?
How you spell yeah. It? Yeah.
Spatial well, with a T.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Have you got 7 as well? You got 7 as well, Lee?
Yep.
Cool.
What's your 7?
Spatial.
Yeah.
What did you write down on the bit of paper?
Oh, that was I put down hospital.
Like a Cockney would say hospital.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know if you know this, but hospital with an H is only for hospitals with a helicopter landing pad.
In a sentence, it'd be like, I suspected my opponent was cheating, so I put him in hospital.
Yes. 7 points to John's team. Susie, Nigel, could they have done any better?
No, we got 7 spatial and we also got top sail.
So at the end of that, John and Jessica are in the lead with 7 points. On to our first numbers round. OK, Lee, Joe, you get to pick the numbers.
All right, then we'll have one from the top.
Yeah.
And we'll have the rest from
the bottom.
Wherever the rest from the bottom bits.
Yep. 1 big, 5 little. 7, 5.
I'm out.
1, 3. 6 and 50. And the target, 605.
OK, and your time starts now.
Oh. Oh, no, have I done it?
Yeah. So the target was 605. Jessica, did you get it?
No, I got 606.
OK. Did you get it, John? You got it? Lee, did you get it?
7. Hospital.
Joe?
I got it.
You got it, OK.
Yes, I got it, yeah.
OK, how did you get it?
OK. <Yeah. laughs> Take the 3,
yep.
minus the 1. Times that by the big one.
100.
100. Times that by the 6. The
600.
Simple little 6. And then... bung the 5 on, whatever.
So you know what?
Joe Wilkinson. Joe Wilkinson got it.
It's going! It smashed the studio up.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it's incredible. How do we top that? We can't.
John, did you do it the same way?
Admittedly, without the panache.
You didn't get it.
No, I was outsmarted by Joe Wilkinson. It's rock bottom.
Yeah, it's rock bottom. 10 points to both teams. OK, the scores at the moment, Lee and Joe have 10 points, John and Jessica have 17 points. 10 points. And here's your teaser. The words are pea sting. The clue is try soaking it. That's pea sting, try soaking it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were pea sting. The clue was try soaking it. It was, of course, steeping. OK, John, Jessica are in the lead. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for John and Lee. So, Lee, your turn to choose.
I'll have a consonant, please. And a vowel.
E.
Another consonant.
C.
A vowel, please.
I.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
R.
A vowel, please.
A.
A consonant, please.
W. Oh,
what do you reckon, John?
That's too late now. You've ruined it.
I'll go for a consonant, please.
And a final. N.
A little game of crazy golf, Rachel. Right, your time starts now. I'll go first. You have a go. You've put a lot of spin on that, haven't you?
I've been practicing.
Can I ask genuinely, how did you do it?
Well, what she does, she sort of, it's almost like a bit of top spin on it.
No. How did they make the ball do that?
I'll put it on here. It's a regular ball, yeah. But it's got a little tiny bit of magic in it. If you just roll it into his lap there and up his bum.
Whoever's doing that, you're a wonderful, wonderful man.
Lee, how many?
7. Hospital. 7.
John, how many?
Well, I'll try a 7, but I don't like it. Carmine.
Carmine?
Yeah, it means vivid crimson.
Wow. Yeah. Lee, what's your seven?
Mine is mine car. Which is, no, it's Cannia.
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 Yes, you are. Yeah. 7 points for both teams. And, Susie Dent there, I mean, you look pretty excited with that.
I was impressed, yeah, 7 for that.
I know what I'm doing, you know, like the Cannia pigeon.
Yeah. Excellent work, both of you. Yeah. 7 points for both of you. OK, at the end of that, Lee and Joe have 17 points, John and Jessica have 24. OK, right, now time for Joe and Jessica to go head-to-head in the maths. Are you feeling confident, Jessica?
God, well, not after that, no.
You spent a lot of time living in Los Angeles, but you grew up in Yorkshire. What's the main difference you notice?
Well, I think the big difference is that, I suppose, what we would call a good time here.
Right.
In LA, they would call it a serious drinking problem. One big one from the top and five from the bottom, please.
Rachel, can we have the same numbers and the same result as the last one?
You can handle it, Joe. You've had proper training.
Yeah, come on, Joe.
5, 8, 2, 6, 9, and 100.
Yes, there's 100. We're in with the chance.
Loves 100.
Oh, come on.
Yes! Yes!
Spin again. The target is 660. Your time starts now.
Oh, this is ball bag.
It was 660.
No, please, Jessica, Joe. Please,
Jessica,
don't.
Did you get it?
No.
How close did you get, Jessica? How close did you get?
658.
658. So you got pretty close. Joe Wilkinson, did you get it?
I think I might.
Joe, how did you get it?
100 plus 9. Yeah. Times 6.
654.
8 minus the 2.
Yeah, is another 6.
Oh!
Oh my God.
I mean, this is exceptional. This is exceptional.
I'm in. Quick question. Has that ever been done before? This is going to make the papers.
Yeah. 10 points to Joe Wilkinson, everyone. OK, time now to go across the dictionary corner. Nigel, what did you get up to during lockdown?
I'm obsessed. I've been obsessed with bad cooking on the internet, and I make videos bitching about them. And, you know, that's what we all need, right? Me bitching about things that don't concern me.
Can you show us some examples? Can we see
some? Yeah, of course. Why do you think a laptop was here, you know? All right, so this is an extraordinary video, a homemade video I found of someone making spaghetti bolognese. Oh, well, attempting to make spaghetti bolognese. So here we go.
So right there in the center, we're gonna do one more. Hi-ya! All right, here's my next set.
What?
Yeah.
What is going on there? Why don't you show us that? That's an abomination.
I don't know if she knows what spaghetti bolognese is supposed to look like, but it's not supposed to look like uncooked spaghetti wrapped by dog poo.
There's bell more. Peppers, onion, yellow bell peppers. Wait, we got one more special ingredient.
You're putting nerds in
yes,
there.
Yes. They're gonna release the sugars.
Where did you get this recipe from? The dark web?
All right, it's been 20 minutes. Ooh. Oh, yeah.
That looks amazing.
I actually made my own Getty spaghetti.
You've made your own Getty spaghetti.
Oh, good God.
Oh, my God.
What did you do before it started? Wait a second. It turns out he's a magician and he's bloody good.
There was nothing under that.
I would like to see you eat some.
All right.
Oh, my God. That is vile.
No. Oh, please.
Wow. Getty spaghetti.
Oh.
How is it?
Really good.
Nudge along, everyone. The scores at the moment, John and Jessica are on 24 points. Lee and Joe are in the lead with 27. And here is your teaser. The words are poosting, and the clue is try bending over. That's poosting. Try bending over. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease. The words were poosting. The clue was try bending over. It was, of course, stooping. OK, before we carry on with the game, time for a quick bonus round. It's the return of Carrot in a Box. So, John Lee, please come and join me in the Carrot in a Box Thunderdome. John, you have never won Carrot in a Box.
It's not a game I enjoy, Jimmy. I like to be presented with the facts and, you know, let's all just try and make a word. I don't see why you'd build a game out of deception.
OK, Lee, you've never played Carrot in a Box before. Do you think you're going to be able to beat John?
I'm just glad you did. When you rang me up and said, we're thinking of doing apple in the anus, and I said, please don't do apple in the anus.
This is a game of bluffs. One of these boxes contains a carrot. You want to end up with the carrot in your box.
Why?
Because then you win the
win
carrot.
What? Win the carrot?
Yeah.
Can we just, like, break it in half and just go back to our seats?
In a moment, I'll ask you to look in your box and you'll see whether there's a carrot in there or not. And then John is allowed to swap his box with you. Lee, you want the carrot? John, you want the carrot. But there is only one carrot. Let's play. Let's play Carrot in a Box. Lee, you can look in your box now. Don't tell John if there's a carrot in your box.
I've worked it out. I'm not an idiot. Right, and do I mention this carrot? Or do I not mention the carrot?
OK, Lee, what do you want to do?
Right, so I have to say to him what?
Whether you want to keep the box or whether you want him to swap with you. He's the one that decides right. Whether he wants to swap the box or keep his box.
Right, John, you know what he just said then?
Yeah.
Well, imagine me saying it. Do you want to keep the box you've got, or do you want this box with the carrot in it? Or it might not have a carrot in it. It might be an empty box. But I'll tell you something, one way or the other, one of us goes home today with a carrot. John, do you want to take this carrot? You should be doing this. I should be looking disinterested.
Can I have a look in the box?
Can I show Joe inside of the box?
Sure.
Yeah.
This is big because Joe's never seen a carrot.
Right. Don't react when you see the carrot.
All right.
All right.
How was it, Joe?
It was on a black silk cushion and the carrot was sunk in it.
How long is this carrot?
This carrot is, I would say, are you including what?
Bigger
what?
Than the box. Wow. It's, shit.
It's
going to be diced. It's a dice.
It's about that long.
This has really pissed me off because I was certain
yeah.
There was no carrot in that box.
Oh, there's a carrot in the box. What made you think there wasn't a carrot in the box?
When you moved it over there and nothing rattled around. There was no sound. I know the sound of a carrot rattling around in the box.
I'm very stealth. I mean, I've honestly, the amount of times I've walked into my house late at night, drunk as a skunk, with a carrot in a box, and still managed to get upstairs and put it by my bed without my wife waking up and going, you haven't brought a carrot home in a box again, have you? £200! I'm supposed to go to our son's school fees. You've ended up buying carrots in a box.
Where's your wife from again?
She's, we do role play. I said to her, next time we might look, and you pretend you're Johnny Vegas. So, well, look, do you want my carrot in the box?
No carrot in that box. Keep it in my box, Jimmy.
Normally, you're in your own head and you're all over the place. You seem so confident this evening, it's wonderful to see. OK,
give me a minute, then, because I didn't like you. They wouldn't glue the carrot down because you want the moment of me lifting the carrot out of the box. This is all a tissue of lies.
I mean, they said naked attraction wouldn't work, didn't they? I've always wanted to go on that show and then just get a prosthetic penis just there. So when the first bit lifts up, they just go, yeah, I don't need to see the rest, I'll have him. Get it back on track. Do you want the carrot?
So you said he's keeping his, so you're keeping your...
keeping my box, yeah, mate.
Okay, okay, final answer?
Carrot, in there.
Okay, let's find out who's won. John, look in your box.
Here comes a carrot. You fucking...
Okay, Lee is the winner of Carrot in a Box. Look how upset he is. Look how upset he is. That's the end of the game.
How can you be so shit in a shit game?
If you listen carefully, you watch this back, I even give you a little subtle clue. I said, there's a carrot in this box. And then I gave you another subtle clue. I said, Joe, is there a carrot in this box? He went, yeah, there's a carrot in this box.
You said that was on a black cushion. Game is null and void. Game is null
and void. Remarked everyone, the winner of Carrot in a Box.
I'm going to play this at home. I'm going to get back tonight at 4 a.m. Kids, get up! We're playing Carrot in a Box! I'm the champion!
OK, on with the game. John, Jessica, your turn to choose the letters.
This is the real game. At least we're winning at the real game.
You're not winning at the real game. It's 27 plays 24.
Unbelievable. It's statistically incredible.
Let
and
it
what's
go.
Even more incredible is that I give a flying toss.
Are you going to wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning and hate yourself?
I'll still be up at 3 o'clock in the morning, mate. Don't you worry about that. There's no sleep for me tonight. I shall be down the greengrocer's banging on the door. Open up, Kevin! Give me 68 carrots and... fucking one box. Jam them all in there. Let's see how many carrots in the box. We'll have a vowel, please, Rachel.
I.
A consonant.
R.
Consonant, please.
T.
Oh, please be a D. Then I can have dirt to put my carrot in.
Another consonant, please.
G.
And another consonant, please.
D.
Another vowel, please.
U.
These are bad as well. My whole life is falling apart. Another vowel, please. A better one.
O.
Consonant, please.
M.
Vowel.
A.
OK, and your time starts now. John, how many letters?
Five.
Five?
Yeah.
You're not even good at this anymore, are you? Jessica, how many?
Oh, it's not a word, so... it's...
How many?
Well, I'm going to just say five.
Lee, how many?
Five.
Joe?
Five.
So, Joe, you're five?
Trim. Well, that's four. I want everyone else to say five. But I just didn't want to be left out.
OK, Lee, you're five.
Grout.
John, you're five?
Radio.
What was it?
Radio!
Oh, brilliant.
Jessica?
Great. G-R-A-I-T. It might be a different type of great.
Great, that looks like a word. Is that a word?
No.
Ah!
What? Oh, sorry, John.
Well, thanks anyway, because I just remembered I could grate this carrot with it.
It's such a shit game to lose at. You can't, there's no, like... It's not like losing at Wembley.
Can we give John one of our points?
That is the worst thing that's ever happened. You just did there.
Hang on, I'll take it one step further, Jimmy. I'd like to give John my carrot. I'll tell you what, I'll give you a chance. Which hand's it in?
Five points to both teams. Nigel, Susie should have done it better.
Yeah,
this
one's got seven.
Yeah, Susie found auditor. And we have a second word that's also seven. How do you pronounce this?
A gourami. I think, well, it's an Asian fish, brightly coloured Asian fish, apparently.
Oh, yeah.
Popped it in just aquarium. Said
that, like, oh, maybe you know him. You know brightly coloured Asian fish, you probably know him.
Yeah.
OK, so at the end of that, Lee and Joe are in the lead with 32 points. Time to go across to Victory Corner. Nigel, what have you got for us?
Oh, glad you asked, Jimmy. I have sushi. Mm. Yes. If I weren't a comedian, if I could do my whole life over, I think I'd be a sushi chef, you know?
Did you make those yourself?
No, I didn't make these myself. I got them from Britain's most renowned sushi joint, Boots Drugstore. Can you imagine a Japanese sushi chef who worked his whole life trying to make the perfect sushi, and then he's like feeling a bit peckish, and he wonders what this Boots meal deal is. And he goes in there, he's like, oh shit, condoms, lube, my life's work. You know? And they put our soy sauce in the plastic fish. You know? They just seduce you with the Boots meal deal, you know? You guys like a deal here. Mm. You see three things cost less than two things, you lose your shit. And when you get a meal deal, you get a pack of free crisps. Who is pairing sushi with Walkers? That's what I want to know, right? Who's eating that and then going, you know what this raw fish needs? Cheese and onion. What are you going to get for your drink, Susie? Ribena? I think the people who buy sushi from Boots are the same people who would buy a dildo from Poundland.
To be fair, Poundland does sound like a sex shop.
Nigel Hung, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are nut sting, and the clue is minor tiny. That's nut sting, minor tiny. See you after the break. To the defeat. The words weren't nut sting, the clue was minor tiny. It was, of course, stunting. Mm-hmm. Okay, time for our final letters game. Lee, Joe, your turn to choose.
Consonant, please.
G.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
C.
Consonant.
P.
A vowel, please.
And I.
And a consonant.
S.
Another vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
F.
A consonant, please.
And another G.
So your time starts now. Dear Diary, I've been feeling really guilty about all the nasty things I say about John, about how he's boring and tiny, and how his voice is really nasal and annoying, and how he looks like a rat boy. All those things are true, of course, but I feel bad about saying it, because the thing is, I love John. I really love him. Not in a sexy way, although he is sexy, more in a friendly, would love to hug him type way. Hug him and hold him tight to me, like best friends do. I just wish I had the guts to tell him that I love him, that I love John Richardson. John, I've got something to tell you.
What?
You're a little rat boy loser. Lee, how many?
Seven.
Joe, how many?
A risky seven.
I imagine fucking risky. John, how many?
Yes, a risky seven.
Jessica?
Also a risky seven.
OK, well, let's hear your risky seven, Jessica.
It's piggies.
Yeah, piggies are great. Well
piggies
done.
Are great. Yeah. Joe, your seven?
Peg.
What? Your seven-letter word is peg.
Yeah, it's risky, so I'm worried it wasn't seven.
There's an S there as well, Joe.
Fucking example. Nora, I knew that.
Lee, you're seven.
I also had piggies. I've written it down. Don't give me that look.
John, you're seven.
I also had piggies, but I wondered if siggies was a word.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
The other seven.
Siggies.
Piggies.
Piggies and piggies.
Piggies and piggies.
7 points yeah. Of both teams. OK, so John and Jessica have 36 points. Lee and Joe just in the lead with 39 points.
Come on, Joe! Come on, Jim!
OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. OK, it's all on this.
Oh, hold on, where's my buzzer?
What do you need a buzzer for?
Oh, yeah, fine.
OK, your 30 seconds starts now. John.
Heartless.
John Richardson after 9 seconds.
I think it's only fair that we break it in off.
So the final scores are Lee and Joe have 39, John and Jessica have 46 points. Congratulations to John and Jessica. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Picture Hanging Kit. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you watching at home. That's all from us. Good night.
Olympian Ewan Thomas, Ollie Locke and the Vivian become mini Jason Bournes for Stand Up To Cancer in brand new Celebrity Hunted. Get ready to hide Sunday night at 9. In your weekly dose of ripping apart the news, the Adam Hills way couldn't come at a better time. Nish Kumar and Sandy Toksvig cut the ribbon on the brand new series of The Last Leg Live. And next.